have like two family, one individual and one family from Philippines. Okay, it's very similar to the Philippine language. You call it the Tagalog. Okay, but instead, selamat for them means thank you, right? Thank you. But for us in Malaysia, selamat means safe. Pagi means morning. So I'm wishing you a safe morning or a well morning in Malaysian, in the Malaysian language lah. Okay, but Malaysian language is very easy to pick up. Even if you do not know what it means, you're still able to pronounce it. So wherever you go, you see the letters being romanized. So you have A, B, C, D instead of our own distinctive writing. During the days of old, Malaysian language, you used to use the Arabic writing. But because of the diversity, because we have the Chinese and the Indians in this country, that's why we had to accommodate all of them. So if we accommodate all of them, we use the romanized language where everyone will understand, to standardize it so we can all understand it. But now, for myself, like myself, okay, I'm a fourth generation Chinese, okay, and I no longer identify myself as the as a Chinese
person. First time here in Malaysia, or you've been here before? First time. Any second timers? Second time. Oh, you've been here second time. You've been here second time, is it? No. Any second timers? No. Oh, second time already. Oh, okay, let's see. Wait. Kuala Lumpur or elsewhere? KL also, for work or for holiday? Holiday also. You live Malaysia, is it? Yes. Alright, okay. Basically, this is Malaysia. We are like this. But I think one of the things that we can sort of promote or be very proud of is diversity. Now, a lot of people ask us, like, what's so special about Malaysia? I mean, everywhere you have diversity. Philippines, Vietnam, Singapore, where else? Australia, yes, Australia. Especially in Melbourne, right? That's the most livable city at the present moment. But what is it that sets us apart? Like, what is it that we celebrate about diversity so much? Okay, let me just explain to you like how the Chinese and the Indians first came here. Now, if you do a bit of read up about Malaysia, they emphasize a lot on the three main races, right? Okay, the Malays, the Chinese, and the Indians. Okay, the Malays, they are the majority of the population. Okay, they're about 60%. In Malaysia, they're about 33 million. And 60% are the Malays. 20-25% are Chinese, and 10% are the Indians. But I think the number has dwindled already. Okay, and you have other minority groups. Now, in Malaysia, you are free to practice whatever religion you want. Okay, not only that, you are free to keep your name. Free to see your practice, your religion, your own language, you can. But one thing is for sure, all Malaysians must converse in the Malaysian language. You must. You have to. You cannot say, oh, I don't want. You have to. So, for example, if I do not know how to speak Tamil, and he doesn't know how to speak Chinese, Malik doesn't know how to speak Chinese, we have one language that would bring us together. That is the Malaysian language. So that's how we communicate. Okay? And you are free to keep your name as long as you have an identification card that states that you are Malaysian. That's about it. That's only about it. And you must respect the constitution. And apart from that, in Malaysia, do you know there are three things that you're not supposed to talk bad about? You're not supposed to demean or demonize anything. The first is the king. You cannot talk bad about a king. The second is race and religion. And that's why if people ask us, is Malaysia a liberal nation? I can say yes and no. We're like 50-50. We have a certain degree of liberalism, but too much of it is not good. You know why? If you have too much to say whatever you want, there's no peace anymore. If you're free to go around and say, the Hindus are like that. The
one Muslims hotel isn't enough, so you decide to build five. Yeah, really, five. And with the largest one in the world being here in terms of room capacity. The capacity of the rooms. There are about 7,000 over rooms in that place alone. And that's called the First World Hotel. Now, when you sit on a cable car, you will pass by, if you can see, if it's on a clear day, the last time I went there, it wasn't clear at all. If you see there's like a rainbow, then you feel, okay? Alright, God is with you. Alright, now, Mr. Malik will drop us at the right here, there's a bus station. And on the left, can you see GPO? It's Genting Premium Outlet. Alright, it's a place where they sell like branded goods at off-season price. Okay, this is not Chinatown, okay? No, it's not. Okay, it's Genting Kirin Outlet. You can actually visit this place. It's entirely up to you what you want to do. As long as we meet you guys here, I will show it to you where the platform we're going to meet.
Thank you.
66.
Isabel.
Hi, you. You like this with my father.
No.
Oh, you're swimming.
Oops, sorry. Isabel.
We are flying!
Yeah, flying!
Yeah!
Fire!
Are you okay?
Mm. Yeah!
Naiyakan mo pag-video. Paano ka mag-artista?
What's behind you?
Transformation plan.
We go up!
We're going up!
We're
going up! Parang gaming channel lang po. Patalasan gaming channel lang po.
Bago ba tayo, mami?
Sa temple.
Oo, sa temple.
Yun yung ma-orange, di ba, ma?
Para siguro masaya kung ano yan, glass na yung sinap niya. Tapos
mo dyan,
mag-ilamoy yung lalim. Parang yung bata nga dun, inaano, ina-assist ni Dallas.
I can see bata.
Parang ano, siguro nahihilo siya or ayaw niya sa makayo, natakot siya.
Ako nga po, kung ano, nakataas lang ba ako na ako sa taas. Nakatigil sa taas.
Yes. Ang lamig! Excuse me! Here? Going to temple? Ah, okay. Miriam! Ang lamig nga eh. It's windy. Saan tayo pupunta, Miriam? Temple?
Going to the temple. Lamig.
bagay pa ah. Go to the temple. Bagi pak.